Good morning. Welcome to the house of the Lord this morning. A little side heavy this morning. You know what? I am so happy and so glad that you thought it important this morning to be here. Especially as we celebrate our grads, as we recognize them this morning in our service. And from the bottom of my heart this morning, I just want to thank you for coming this morning and supporting this service. Couple announcements this morning, very brief and to the point. Program has ended for the summer months, except for YP band. I believe tomorrow night is our last YP band practice tomorrow evening. Next Sunday is another very special Sunday in the life of Mount Pearl Citadel. It's Father's Day, so we get to celebrate fathers, but we're also having a junior and senior soldier enrollment next Sunday morning within that service. And we have, I think, 6 junior soldiers being enrolled, and we have 1 senior soldier being enrolled. We put out a plea last fall, and we put out a plea again early January, February, for this enrollment, and this is who we've had come forward. But do not fret. If you're still interested in becoming a senior soldier, or if your littles is of the age September, to be a junior soldier, we are planning another one come the fall. Some more classes to be done and another enrollment this fall. So please keep that in mind, pray about it, and you feel that this is something that God is calling you to. Just let us know. This morning we also want to celebrate somebody. Valera has officially retired. Officially retired after so many years in the workforce, and that she is going to enjoy some relaxation for sure. And we celebrate that with you this day. Not very often, I'm speechless. Opening song.
We're going to start the morning with praise and worship. The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty. How great is our God? How great is our God? He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Let's stand this morning as we sing together.
Thank you.
today is a special day, as my husband alluded to in the announcements, and we want to recognize our graduates here at Mount Pearl Citadel, both our littles, our kindergarten graduates, and our high school graduates. And we're going to sing the chorus, If You're Happy and You Know It. Glenn, can you help us out on the piano for that chorus, please? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Good job! She's got it figured out. And I'd say littles are pretty happy that school's over, even the bigger littles. Who's happy that school's almost over? I am too. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it, what do you got to do, Mark? Right on. Let's stand together as we sing, and then we're going to honor our kindergarten graduates. School. And for a little child, like 5-6 years old, that's a lot. And we're proud of you this morning. Now, they all couldn't be here. There's some sickness on the go again, which is too bad. But we do have two with us this morning that we want to come up, and we have a little gift, and we want to acknowledge them as kindergarten graduates. So, Sabrina Bowring and Hudson McDonald. You want to come up, please? And Abigail Glenn and Nathaniel Newell graduating as well, and we'll make sure that they get their little gifts. You stand right here so everyone can see you. Oh, Morgan, watch over the camera so we can see you. Can't see them on this side. Can you see? Wait now, stand a little bit further. Can all see your pretty face? And we're so proud of them that they've accomplished. What did you learn this year? Did you learn how to color inside the lines?
Yeah.
And your numbers? And your alphabet? Did you learn to be kind? And to share? All that good stuff? Adults, we all need to learn that too some days. We're really proud of you for accomplishing kindergarten and graduating. And this is a little gift from us at your church family. And congratulations. Let's give them a hand. We are so proud of you. Now, what's happening in less than a month?
VBS!
Okay, we got some things happening here this morning for VBS. Take it away, guys.
Hey guys, what are you doing? Looks like fun.
Nope.
Hello. Oh, there we go. Nope. This is pure frustration. Hop on board.
So why are you on this train straight to frustration?
Well, bargain shopper over here found this train set online for a screaming deal, and he thought we could use it as a decoration for the Rocky Railroad VBS our church is hosting soon. We're discovering why it was such a bargain.
Uh-oh, is it missing pieces or something?
It's hard to tell. We can't quite figure anything out because whoever sold this converted the instructions into some coded language. Engineer humor. Real funny.
You know what I think? I think you should forget the frustration train and come work on some set pieces with me for Rocky Railway VBS. Check it out. I'm building a way cooler, way bigger train. No mystery language involved, but it's going to carry a message that will help kids know they can trust Jesus' power to pull them through life's ups and downs.
Now that's a screaming deal.
Okay. So this train set was a bust, but it sounds like our Rocky Railway train is going to be amazing. Count me in.
Me too.
Awesome. Just wait till you see how it all turns out. It's all coming together. The kids are going to have an amazing week.
For the most epic adventure ever? Next summer, Group VBS is taking kids on a ride they'll never forget. Get on board the Rocky Railway. Church will be on track at Sing and Play Express. Get ready for high energy fun at Locomotion Games. Experience impactful Bible lessons and Bible adventures. You'll have amazing discoveries at Imagination Station. Take a glimpse into the world of five awesome kids who learn that Jesus' power pulls us through. The best part of summer is full steam ahead at Rocky Railway.
Okay, come on, kids. Are we excited to VBS? Woo-hoo! It's going to be awesome. It's going to be awesome. I just can't wait. July 11th to the 15th here at Mount Pearl Citadel, 6 to 8:30. There's going to be food, and there's going to be games, and there's going to be Bible stories, and there's going to be songs, and there's going to be actions, and it's going to be so much fun. Who's going to be there? Oh, come on. Okay, that's a few. I need a few more, though. We'll get there. Registration is happening. If you haven't received the email from the Corbett registration, just contact me and I'll make sure you get a registration form. And we've got room for lots this year, a lot more than we did last year. And we're looking forward to an exciting week. Ages preschool to grade 6, but you're never too old to help out at VBS. So we need volunteers, and we always need volunteers. So if you're willing to give us a few hours from that week, we greatly appreciate that. And just see me or Renee, and we'll gladly get you on our volunteer list for VBS. Everyone seems to know what's going on there in the back wall. I see people going back taking their little pieces of luggage. Thank you so much. That's the food we need for the week. So if you want to take a couple and write your name on the list to tell us what you're bringing, we greatly, greatly appreciate it. We need all that luggage to disappear. Thank you so much. We also need Christmas trees. No, not for Christmas. We need to create this platform into an amazing rocky railway. So I don't need them all right now, but as it gets closer to July, if you could bring in a Christmas tree, put your name on the box and on the part of the tree itself, we will gladly get it back to you just as you got it brought in, but we're just going to lay them in spaces along our platform to make it look like a forest. So we need Christmas trees. So if you're willing to give me a Christmas tree, please let me know. We also need old-fashioned luggage. Has anyone got any trunks or old-fashioned luggage at home? We'll be really careful with it, we promise. But we just need it for a few props, because right now we have wrapping paper luggage. But that's good. That's good. We spent the other night here making 23 pieces of wrapping paper luggage, and that's all good. But if we had a few antique pieces, it would really add to our set. So if you're able to give us that, just let me know or Renee know, and that would be great. And we need a pair of size overalls to fit Mark. Mark is going to be our engineer for the week. And I'm going thrifting this week, but if I didn't have to go thrifting, that would be awesome. Mark, do you want me to say your size I would over here? Extra large? Or what? Oh, yeah, if anyone can help us out with a pair of overalls that would match, that would fit Mark. Denim overalls, and we'll get them back to you. We just need the loan of them for a week. So thank you so much, and we're really looking forward to our VBS. Thank you to everyone who's volunteered their time so far. And thank you to those who the Holy Spirit will convict this morning, and you will help us out. Good job. Now the band selection, Glenn. And the kids can go out for Sunday school after the band selection.
Thank you. Hebrews 4:16 says, "Let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Let us continue to worship by singing 'Your grace is enough' and give God thanks for His amazing grace." This next song may be new to some of us here, but as we sing it, let us reflect on all the times in our lives when God's goodness was evident. Also, consider the times God's promises have been fulfilled in your own personal life. Join us as we sing Evidence.
Thank you.
Don't before, but it's lovely. Don't we all have evidence in our lives that God is good? Amen? That God is good. We're going to continue in worship. We're going to sing the beautiful song, What a Beautiful Name. Can I have the words, Joy, please? You were the Word at the beginning, one with God, the Lord Most High, your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you our Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. This song actually was selected by one of our graduates this morning, and he chose it for prayer time. We're going to sing that through as written, and then Major Wavy, a grandmother of one of our graduates we're celebrating here this morning, is going to come and pray on behalf of our graduates. I'm sure, though, there's needs in our core this morning. There's needs on our hearts. And as we pray together this morning, whisper those names, and God will hear our prayers. You were the Word at the beginning.
Now reveal in you. During the past weeks, the words of the song, "I want more of Jesus, more and more and more than ever I had before," have been resounding in my mind. And it's in his name that we've met to worship this morning. What a wonderful name, the name of Jesus. And we thank you, our Father, because it's in his name, the name of your Son, that we've assembled to worship you this morning. We cannot thank you enough for your goodness to us, for bringing us to this place of worship where we can meet and share together and sing your praises and listen to your voice speaking to our hearts. And so, our Father, it is with thanksgiving that we come into your presence this morning. Lord, I do not know all the needs of our church this morning, but you know. And I would pray that you will meet the needs of everyone. Maybe there are burdened hearts here and listening. Maybe there are sick souls. Maybe there are cravings that cannot be met by today's standards. Oh, Father, we pray that through your Holy Spirit, you will minister. And as we worship you this morning, may our hearts be calm before you. And may our spirit be in oneness with you. We thank you for life. We thank you for love. We thank you for families. And our Father, our families are so precious to us. And for what we've experienced here this morning, these kindergarten graduates, Lord, they're just starting out in life. Lord, take them in your hands. Mold them. Fashion them. Give them a love for you. And then there are others who have come to the end of that part of schooling, and they are the graduates who will move on into the world to the vocation of their choice. We can only pray, our Father, that you will take these lives and you will give with them the wisdom to seek your guidance in everything that they do, in whatever vocation they choose in life. Our Father, may your blessing and your benediction and your Holy Spirit be with them. And now, our Father, we pray that you will meet our needs as we've met here to worship you. We thank you because you are Jesus. And we thank you because we can have a relationship with you like none other. And Lord, we pray that in these days we will stand firm in the faith. Be with all those who need you today, and may your Spirit speak to our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Now, Nathan and Colby are going to come with our scripture reading.
Jeremiah 29, verse 11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope."
Ephesians 2:10. "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them."
Ephesians 1, verse 6. "And I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Jesus Christ."
Philippians 1:9-10. "And it is my prayer that your love may abound more and more with knowledge and all discernment, so that you may approve what is excellent, and so be pure and blameless for the day of Christ."
Colossians 1:9-10. "And so from the day we heard, we have not ceased to pray for you, asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of his will and all spiritual wisdom and understanding, so as to walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing him, bearing fruit in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God."
scripture to encourage the graduates. Now, we are blessed at Mount Pearl Citadel this year that we have 9 graduating high school students associated with our core. That's pretty amazing. And I can remember the first Sunday I walked in Mount Pearl 3 years ago. Can't believe it was 3 years ago. And I looked around and saw all the young people, and I was said, we are truly, truly blessed. They're not all here this morning. 5 of the 9 are here, but they are all associated with our core. Our core has had an impact on them in some way, and we pray that that impact has been positive. And we pray that you will continue to pray your blessing upon these students. As Major Penny prayed, they're going out into the big world. And we pray that God will give them wisdom and discernment, and they will realize that they serve a faithful God who will be faithful to them when they call on his name. So this morning, I want to congratulate them, and I want to call them. I want them all to stand together so we can get a picture. And we'll start with, I did in alphabetical order, Nathan Elliott. Abigail Hillier. Riley Holland. And stand over here so we can get a picture.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Gavin Hull. Colby Loveless. You're welcome. We also have Ava Ennis, Maya Evans, Gina Miller, and Evan Wicks, who could not be with us this morning, but they will get their gifts as well. Now, as an officer, we go places and move around, so we don't have the roots, but I know many of you have watched these kids grow, and you've spoken into their lives. You've watched these kids grow and you've spoken into their lives. And this is what they've accomplished thus far. And the sky's the limit, guys. And God will be with you. Trust him, believe in him, and he will be faithful. Let's give them a round of applause. And we are also very, very proud of you. God bless. Okay, you can go take your seats. Did you get snap? Good. That's my husband's word, snap. Yeah. You're on.
Another announcement tonight. At 6 o'clock tonight, we are having, and back from a hiatus of a couple of years, Music for Youth concert tonight. So I think we have nine of our youth who's been taking piano lessons, guitar lessons, vocal lessons, all that stuff that they've been tied up in for the last number of weeks. Well, we're bringing 9 of them into our church this evening, and they're going to put off a recital this evening, as well as our YP band as well. After that tonight, there will be fellowship, tea, coffee, ice cream, muffins, maybe some toast. No, she says no. Okay, muffins and ice cream and tea and coffee will be served in our YPL this evening. So please come out. That's at 6 o'clock this evening, so please come out for that. And another announcement, and I'm just going to put it out there and leave it, and you can see my wife. My wife has some shirts, white shirts, 2 brand new ones, still in plastic. They're open neck blouses for the summer, and one that's been very gently used. I'm not going to tell you the size of them, and just to say they're a little bit too small for Lisa. So if you're that size, then you need a new shirt, see my wife after. They have the crest on them and epaulets things. And we also have some summer epaulets as well. If you are in uniform and you need some blue epaulets, we have some available as well if you are looking for that. Grads, graduates, 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 and I'm going to be looking all over the place this morning. Didn't they look amazing in their black and white, blue this morning? We were hoping to have them kind of dressed up, but some of them are not, haven't had their grad yet. So I'm sure in the next couple of weeks you will see many of their faces on social media, as well as the kindergarten grads in their probably cap and gown and their nice outfits as well. So keep an eye on social media and comment on how amazing they will look. I'm sure that they will look. And I just have very short, I've been warned this morning, not to be too long with this, and it's going to be very, very brief. And Lisa mentioned this morning that you're awesome, and we've only been here for 3 years, but you as a congregation, and I'm going to refer to you this morning as their village. Their village. You have watched these amazing youth grow up into the young adults that they are today. They are unique. They are kind. They are amazing. They're talented. And the list can go on and on this morning about all 9 of our young people and all 4 of our kindergarten graduates. And graduates this morning, you have so many people cheering you on. Not just today and forward, but you've had so many people cheering you on for the past 12 years, 13 years of school. So many people here, your village, that see so much potential in you. So much potential in you. So many dreams that we see that God can use you in this world today. I had a dream once. I had a dream of what I wanted to be. What Morgan Hillier wanted to be. I wanted to play in the NHL. Not for the Leafs, Jim. They would have been worse than I am no Mitch Marner or Matthews by a long shot. But I wanted to play in the NHL. Seriously, I played hockey growing up and not that great, so obviously I did not make it to the NHL. If my mother, Blanche, had her way, I would probably be still in St. Anthony today. Guaranteed. Probably. More than likely. Working in the fish plant in St. Anthony. Cutting out tongues and bridges in the fish plant in St. Anthony. Not that that's a bad thing, because somebody has to do it. We all love to eat these things, and somebody has to cut it out. But it wasn't for me. And I look at my wife this morning, and you can kind of say that she rescued me from that. She rescued me. Well, what are your dreams? And I'm not going to put you on the spot this morning, graduates, of what your dreams are. But as I look at you and as I see you, I see nurses. I see managers. I see instructors. I see maybe politicians. There may be a general of the Salvation Army here this morning. Salvation Army officers, do not limit what you can do. Dreams are important. Following your dreams is vital. And the important element to totally realize is that they are your dreams. Your dreams. What you strive for. To be. Not what your friends want you to be. Not what we want you to be. They are your dreams, your aspirations. Be who you are. Be who God made you to be. He designed you to be amazing. He designed you to be unique. To be all that you are created to be. There's a slogan that the Navy has, and it says, be all that you can be in the Navy. Change that. to be all that you can be in life today, in whatever path that you choose. You are the only you there is. That's it. There is nobody else like you. So be the best that you can be. If you aren't you, the world misses out on you, on who you are. Believe in you and believe in what you can accomplish in life. A couple of scriptures that I want to leave with you today and for you to remember as you start the journey. As you start the journey. The first passage has been repeated here this morning. Been repeated many times. I've heard it a few times. I've heard it at youth group the other night. It's used in church graduation services. Put on bookmarks. Put on keychains. Used as a verse of encouragement. Almost stamped on graduates' heads for the past 10 years of this verse. Can anybody guess which one it is? Jeremiah 29 and 11. A reminder that God has a plan for your life. It's a personal plan. It's a plan with a focus. For I know the plans I have for you. Plans I have for you. Plans to prosper you. Plans to harm, not to harm you, plans to give you hope, plans to give you a future. But what when things are not going the way you want it to go? Does this plan still apply? Does this plan still encourage you? It should. If you are trusting in God, if you are believing in Him, then what He says to us should be taken absolutely serious. God does have a plan for our lives. His plans are the best plans, regardless of what they are. Regardless if you're in a fish plant cutting out tongues and bridges, or if you're a teacher in a school, His plans are important where He directs you. Where He directs you. Problem is not the plan, but we have to have trust in His plan. Secondly, a passage that I want you to remember is no matter what happens on your journey, no matter what challenges or falls you may encounter, no matter if the plan you made for your future hits rock bottom, no matter how you feel, no matter how many times you get anxious, stressed, or discouraged, always remember who you are. Always remember there is home. Always remember that you have your village. Always remember you have your village. A village that's always there. A village that no matter what the turns, the twists, or the tumbles your journey takes you, your village is here. Remember that you are loved. Always. Always. Never forget that. Never forget. There is nothing, absolutely nothing, that you can do that would cause us as your village to stop loving you. Nothing. And this is not just for grad day, but always. There's nothing, and I hope I speak for everybody this morning. There is nothing, absolutely nothing, that you can do that will cause your village to stop loving you. Jeremiah 31, this is the second passage, states that I love you with an everlasting love. And therefore, I have continued my faithfulness to you. There is nothing you can do. And I'm restating this, and I want to get that clear this morning. Everybody in earshot, whether you're watching on live stream, if you're here with us this morning, there is nothing you can do that will take you outside of God's love, but also will cause us, your village, to stop loving you. And I hope you hear this today. Graduates and the village, I hope you heed this today. God is always there. Your village is always here. And don't allow anything or anyone to cause you to think otherwise. We love them, don't we? Village, we love them. Them all. Kindergartens, grade 12s, whether you're in high school, if you're in university today, if you're in the workforce today, we love you. And there's nothing that will cause us to stop loving you. To stop loving you. We are here for you. And we will continue to pray for you. A couple of words that has meant a lot to me in the past years. And everybody knows my mantra. It's not a secret. It's be still. Be still. In the midst of it all. In the midst of everything you will encounter in life, pause, breathe, and remind yourself, as some of our teenagers say, one of these words is, you got this. You got this. You got this because you have a village that's praying for you and a village that's supporting you. You got this because God loves you and He knows the plans that He has for you. The second word that means so much to me is overcomer. I have two of them tattooed on my arms. Is overcomer. There's nothing in life that you face, nothing that you cannot overcome. Be still, and you will overcome. Our worship team is going to lead us in a song that I want you to take with you, graduates. It's I'm in His hands. Whatever the future holds, whatever it looks like for you, remember that you're in His hands. The days you cannot see, we have no clue what tomorrow holds, but God holds it. And He holds you in His palm because His way is best. No matter how many times you fall, no matter how many times you stumble, no matter how many times you may think that you're not good enough, you are. You are. Because you are an overcomer. And you have a village and a God that loves you, loves you. There's nothing you can do that will take you outside of our love. Worship team, this morning. Actually, I'm going to have a prayer first. Let's have a prayer. Father, this morning, we thank you for our graduates, kindergartens, grade 12. We thank you for their lives. We thank you for the uniqueness that they all bring to this table. And they all sit at this table because the table is for everyone. There's no limit to who can sit at the table. We thank you for that. And Father, as they prepare for their celebrations for their cap and gowns and for their gatherings and get-togethers and parties and all the stuff that graduation week encompasses. We pray for your protection on our graduates. We pray that they will take these days, fill their lives with memories of their high school years and the friendships that they formed. And may we as the village continue to love and can support them in whatever venture they go, in whoever they may become. May we show our love. May we continue to encourage. May we not be a stumbling block to these young people. May we allow them to be who you created them to be, themselves. Bless them. We thank you for every good and perfect gift, which includes our young people. We thank you for them. Bless us. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Worship team.
And it doesn't matter where we're on our journey. We're never taken out of the hands of God. And whatever our days before us, and however many they may be, they've all been planned because his way is best, you see. I'm in his hands. Let's sing it once more. Let's stand as a congregation as an affirmation of our faith this morning. I'm in his hands, whatever the future holds. Just once more, worship team, please.
I'm in his hands.
We're going to conclude our service this morning on another affirmation of faith. What a faithful God have I. Lord, I come before your throne of grace. I find rest in your presence and fullness of joy. In worship and wonder, I behold your face, singing, what a faithful God have I. And graduates, just remember that we serve a faithful God who is always with us in the good times, in the bad times, and he will see us through. Lord, I come before your throne of grace. With our closing prayer, and then the worship team is going to bless us with the blessing as our singing benediction.
As graduates, may God's blessing follow us all as we find new journeys to travel. May we walk safely along the pathways of our dreams. May his gentle hand guide the decisions we will make and the passions that we follow. May our hearts and lives always reflect his love and truth, and may hope be a light within us that we carry into each new day. Amen.